just 62 days left until Election Day, suburban white women in battleground states are expected to be a big factor in the outcome. So we wanted to see how they're feeling today. We gathered six women, all of whom voted for Donald Trump in 2016. But not all of them still feel good about that vote. Here's our latest Pulse of the People. All right, show of hands, how many of you voted for Donald Trump in 2016? All of you. Okay, show of hands. How many of you plan to vote for him in 2020? Now, you know, just because you raised two hands doesn't mean you can vote twice. I just want to be clear.
That's we do know
just
that.
Just vote.
Okay, so three of you plan to vote for him again in 2020. How many of you plan to vote for Joe Biden? Okay, three hands went up there, the bottom row. So, Anne, let me just start with you. How did President Trump lose your vote?
I voted for him in 2016 because he wasn't a normal politician. I have to admit, I didn't pay too much attention until the pandemic started. The pandemic was when my eyes began to open, and June 1st, when he set U.S. troops on peaceful protesters in Lafayette Square, that was my cross-the-line moment.
Mm-hmm. And how do you feel now about your 2016 vote for him?
I think it's one of, if not the biggest mistake I've ever made in my life. I feel like voting for him helped kill over 100,000 Americans.
So, Jessica, what do you think of the president's response to COVID?
It's been abysmal. He's disappointed and abandoned the American people. My defining moment is when he said he takes no responsibility. Buck stops with you. You took the job, do the job.
For me, it started almost immediately from day one when he lied about how big the crowd was at his inauguration. And I have tracked him since then, and he lies every day to us. I don't know. The one thing he has told the truth about, he has not taken one ounce of responsibility for COVID. From day one, we should have had a national mandate on wearing masks. We could have had this thing under control in 6 weeks if he had just done his job.
LA, what is it like for you as a Trump supporter to listen to your fellow panelists who have, you know, more than soured on him?
I think that they're blatantly wrong, with all due respect. I think Donald Trump has done an amazing job from day one, an amazing job through the pandemic. No, he did not cause the pandemic. So when he says, it is not my responsibility, I did not cause this, that is correct. No one could have done a better job, in my opinion, no one.
He is the only leader that hasn't followed the science, the data, and the experts' advice. 4% of the world's population, we should have under 50,000 deaths. We have over 180,000 deaths. That's not doing a good job.
Let's talk about the death toll. Has everyone read the CDC report that just came out? My goodness, it is a fraction of what they originally said.
What the CDC says is that 6% of the people who've died from COVID also had comorbidities, such as diabetes, but they would still be here today if they hadn't gotten COVID.
Well, then we'll agree to disagree.
So just to be clear, Ella, you don't believe that 183,000 Americans have died?
Not of COVID, no.
I want you to know that I'm a nurse, and I've been a nurse for 27 years, and the response to the pandemic has actually been President Trump's greatest achievement. He was the one that closed off all travel at the beginning of February. Do you guys remember what was happening in January? There were no other elected officials that were even thinking about COVID because they were busy doing their impeachment. Joe Biden, he was the vice president for 8 years. So why didn't they prepare for a pandemic?
They did prepare a pandemic playbook that the Department of Homeland Security under President Obama handed over to the Trump administration. They had a pandemic office, which President Trump shut down. And so they say that they did try to prepare the incoming administration.
I am also a person. I'm a medical information administrator, worked in hospitals for 25 years. And I think President Trump actually has done a pretty good job. I am impressed. I am impressed with how he has garnered the help of the private sector to help indeed get a vaccine going, bring in the PPEs in, developing new ventilators. It's all been good.
At the moment, President Trump, according to the latest polls, is not doing well with women. I think he has something like a 33% of all women approval rate, a 65% disapproval rate. What are your thoughts on that?
I don't look at polls. I just talk to the facts. If you watch the RNC as opposed to the DNC, the RNC was filled with people from across this country, people of every race, people of every creed, people of every background, socioeconomic status.
And wasn't the DNC also? The DNC showing diversity also?
No, the DNC was very... I didn't see all of it, I will say that, but all of the clips, I've probably watched about 2 hours of clips, and it was very much, the attitude is, just get rid of President Trump.
I would say the RNC convention tripled my opinion that he is inclusive, that he is for sure not racist.
And I want to ask the bottom row, who do not plan to vote for him again, did the RNC ladies give you any second thoughts because you heard so many testimonials from people who supported President Trump?
Absolutely not.
Why
He's
not?
A I mean, fan, and they were all his, they are all, as long as you're a Republican and you go along with the party line, he's your best buddy. If you don't, you're a do-nothing Democrat.
I was a lifelong Republican, but the Republican Party no longer exists. It's Trumpism. I mean, when was the last time the Republican Party did not put out a platform? When was the last time any convention was held on government property?
I have a big following on Facebook and everything. I've got thousands of friends. I can tell you they're voting for Donald Trump. I literally do not know one person that voted for him in 2016 that's not going to vote for him again.
And I also have voted Republican far more often in my life than I voted Democrat. But I got to say, I don't know if I will ever vote for a Republican again. I am just sickened by the fact that they are not Republicans. They're Trumpers, period. We've lost the Republican Party. It's gone.